Well, the Windows 11 Major 25H2 update just dropped. They release a new major feature update every single year, and this year is no different. So I'm going to go over the biggest new features, changes, and anything that was removed as well. This update will roll out over time, but if you want to get it right now and you're on 24H2, the previous year's version, you can get it by going into the Windows update and then making sure you have get the latest updates as soon as they're available checked. Now, one thing I want to clarify, I did see several articles all mentioning that there is no new features, which is not really even true. There's actually kind of two sets of features. One is a handful of features that are actually exclusive to 25H2, and then there's another set of features that are released as an update that coincided with 25H2, but I believe you might actually be able to even get, even if you're not on 25H2. So anyway, since they're released at the same time, I'm going to go over all of them. Now, one important caveat, apparently even with these features Microsoft supposedly released, they're not doing it for all people at once. They're doing staged rollouts kind of randomly with A/B testing. And there's also features that I saw that they released, but I didn't even have. I'll still show them, but you might see features that I didn't see, but you'd have. All right, so first up, we have AI actions in the context menu when right-clicking certain types of files. And this is not exclusive to Copilot Plus PCs. I just had it on my regular computer. Basically, when right-clicking certain types of files, you'll have some AI actions, like being able to remove the background with Microsoft Paint, or blur the background with photos, or erase objects, or do a visual search with Bing. For me, at first, these actually didn't even show up, and it turns out that apparently I had to enable them in the settings under Settings, Apps, and then Actions. I saw that for some reason, most of these were disabled. I didn't remember doing that. And then when I enabled them, then is when they showed up in the menu. So the actions that you see will depend on both the apps you have installed that can do them, as well as which ones are enabled in this menu. There's also actions available for document type files if you have Microsoft 365 and you have a Copilot license for that. Now, I don't have the extra Copilot paid subscription, so I don't have that, but this is what it would look like. You'd be able to do things like summarizing or drafting the files. I also noticed there's this describe image system entry that was enabled by default, despite it saying no actions available. So I don't know why that one's not working. You might notice that too. Okay, next up, another change is that in the settings menu, the for developers menu has been renamed to advanced settings. It's basically the same stuff, so that's not a feature in itself. However, there is a new thing in there. If you go to File Explorer, you'll see a new feature called File Explorer Version Control. If you've ever done any coding and you use Git, which is version control, this is what that's for. If you don't know what that is, don't worry about it. But basically, it lets you see right in File Explorer recent information about commits in repositories. Now, you have to add the repository folders manually, which is kind of annoying because I have a whole bunch of them. So I probably won't use this if you have to add each one and you can't add multiple at the same time. In any case, how it works is there's a few column types that you can add to File Explorer that show for this data, like last change date, last change ID, and last change message. And this is just that info about the latest commit for that repository. Anyway, moving on, another change is that the ability to change the date and time formats has moved to settings. It used to be in the control panel. And in here, you can do stuff like changing the symbol for AM and PM, if you just wanted to say A or P or whatever, as well as a bunch of other stuff that you can see. One small new feature is a new keyboard shortcut for typing out N dashes and M dashes. And you do that specifically with the Windows and hyphen key or Windows Shift hyphen key. And then you can see it types out those other types of dashes which are longer than a regular hyphen. Another small new feature is in the sharing menu, you can now pin your favorite apps so they always show up at the top, whereas before it just kind of auto listed them. All right, next up, you can now change the location of the hardware indicators, like if the volume level changes, or as well as the brightness level of the screen, or airplane mode, stuff like that, which is controlled by an external hardware thing, like whether it's your laptop keyboard or an external volume controller. You can now choose where that goes by going into the settings, and then system, notifications, and then position of on-screen indicators. And you can now choose whether it goes at the bottom center, like it does now, or the top left, or top center. Next up, here's a few features that are exclusive to Copilot Plus PCs, meaning they have an NPU. One of them is Click to Do, though this was previously a preview feature, so it's not super new. Now I believe it's just general availability. Anyway, this is the one where you can press, for example, Win plus Q, and it automatically transcribes everything on the screen and lets you copy it as text, or also do stuff with that selected text, like summarizing or things like that. I went more in depth on this one in another video where I talked about Copilot Plus PC features. I can mention that at the end, so I don't want to spend any more time on that. Another new feature for Copilot Plus PCs is what they're calling Agent in Settings. And what this is in the Settings app, for certain tasks or settings that you search for just in plain language, it'll give you an option to immediately apply that as a suggested change. So the example they're giving is if you say, my mouse cursor is too small, it'll say an option to apply right now to make it larger, or you'll also see that relevant setting come up, apparently, to literally just drag the slider right then and there without having to go to the menu. If you press enter on the search, it'll just do a regular search. So you have to remember to not hit enter, and then it'll show the suggested things. It doesn't seem to do this for all settings, though it does seem to be quite a bit. For example, you can also search for live captions. It'll show an option for that, or dark theme or light theme. It'll give you that option to toggle. But some that I found it didn't work for is, for example, if you search enable end task, that doesn't work. That's an option that shows up in advanced or developer menu, but it seems like most of the common ones do show up. And third, another exclusive feature that I really wish they added to regular computers is improved file search. Again, this is something I talked about in my other video, but basically it adds what's called semantic search. And what that does is, say you wanted to search for images that have grass in it. You could search grass and it'll show you images with grass in it, even if there's no metadata or anything that actually mentions the text grass in that file. So that is one I would consider really handy if only I could use it on my main computer. And next up, there's actually a couple things that were removed in 25H2. The first one being PowerShell 2.0. This is a really old version of PowerShell that you were not using anyway, and actually it was a security vulnerability that I suggested you disable anyway, so nothing missed there. And to be clear, that doesn't remove PowerShell, just the extra old version that was still in there. And also, it removed the WMIC command line tool. This is another deprecated tool that you are not using. Only people who work in IT would really care about that, and it's been replaced by the PowerShell commands anyway. Now, one feature I do want to mention that wasn't actually technically added in 25H2, but it was added since the original 24H2, so you might not even know about it, and that is called Quick Machine Recovery. You can find this in the System Settings, then Recovery, and then Quick Machine Recovery. And for me, it was not enabled by default, and I would actually suggest you enable it if it's not already. It seems pretty useful. Basically, if something happens with Windows where it can't boot, it gets corrupted or whatever, normally you know how it tries to do this recovery thing, where it really is not probably gonna succeed. It's very rare that it does. Where this now will do more stuff, and even to the point where it will try to fetch from the Windows update servers, and I think potentially even re-download a new image of Windows and like reinstall all the files. So it has a lot better chance of actually fixing it. And it's not like it's gonna nuke your whole drive and reset all your settings. It would just be able to actually get the known latest actual good files, which might be necessary depending on if the local backup stuff is corrupted, which might even happen. So if you go and see that that's not turned on, I would probably turn it on. So anyway, as far as Windows 11 major annual updates go, this wasn't a huge one, but still, I think I was able to find some that were worth mentioning. I will point out that under the hood, 25H2 uses the same base framework as 24H2, so it shouldn't cause any major new bugs or anything if that's what you're worried about. The update itself from 24H2 to 25H2 is basically just an enablement package where it kind of just says to turn on features that were already added behind the scenes before. So it's almost like nothing at all is going to change in terms of like the architecture of Windows itself through this update. It's just that more features will be visible to you. Anyway, I'd love to hear what you guys think down in the comments, especially if you notice a feature that I didn't talk about. If you want to keep watching, I'll put a link to my video where I mentioned talking about Windows Copilot Plus PC features if you want to see what those are all about. That link's right there you can click on. And of course, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. It helps out. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.